They say we're going to lose an hour today. I said, can I pick it? Glory. Yeah. Hey, can I get mine tomorrow? Hey, man. Man, I am so... It's something about God, man. You... you just think you're tired sometime, and God will just shake you. Man, I am so excited about this word the Lord has given me for the church. Amen. And we had extra time to just sit and meditate on this word. We want to go to Matthew, the 9th chapter. Man, God is just showing different stuff in the same word. Say the same word. God don't have to change. He, when he inspired it, it was already full of everything it needed. Somebody need to learn how to just meditate on the word. Not memorize, meditate. Glory, so it becomes a part of you. I heard David say, I want to hide it in my heart so I will not sin against you. See, sometimes when we don't send up a thank you at the right time, we sin it. Because God is, he's opened it up for us, and he's saying all things are working for your good. Don't matter what it looked like. But right there where you thought I left you, your pain is just opening up your pleasure. Like sweet and sour, glory. I realize how that thing worked now. I told y'all before, I'm like, sweet and sour, how can it be good? But it is. Matthew, the 9th chapter, are you there? Verse 37, we want to lift up two verses and do our best to articulate what the Lord is saying. Amen. Verse 37 reads, then saith he unto his disciples, the harvest truly, say truly, is plenteous, but the laborers are few. Verse 38 says, pray ye therefore the Lord of the harvest, that he will send forth laborers into his harvest. Put your hands together and give the Lord some praise. And then after you do that, look to your neighbor and say, come get your harvest. Come get your harvest. Glory! Say, come get your harvest. Amen. So often we in the church, kingdom citizens, children of the Most High God, don't realize that when God brought you into from eternity into existence, he had produced for you everything you could ever need. God will give us a word like, in all of your getting. See, we want to deal with all of our wanting. But God says, in all of your getting, get understanding. In other words, as you obtain, seek understanding about his desire for you. See, when you begin to understand his desire for you, that is the thing that the enemy, look, that's the only thing he could do was cloud our expectation. And what he does is he has us constantly asking the wrong question. He has us paying too much attention. Seeking an answer that's already been proclaimed. Because he wants to confuse. That's why God said, I am not the author. He said, I didn't write that book. Why you keep reading it? He said, I did not give you the spirit of fear. So why are you still so afraid of your result? God told me, he said, watch this. He said, listen, tell them to come get it. To just come get it. This word says plainly, what you want is there. What you're looking to have manifest in your life is already there. And there's some extra for you. He said, have I not said, try me? And I will open the window, but you got to go in the house. And I will pour out. He said, just try me. In other words, come get it. Expect it. So I said, God, well, we should know that. Yeah, I know, but they won't live it. He said, listen, he said, but the laborers, those that come get the harvest are few. We ask for it, but we don't go get it. God began to put me in the mind of, first of all, watch this. It says, laborer, a person engaged in physical work, a laborer, an unskilled worker. See, we want to get so profound that we pass up the blessing. When I was young, you know, they had the cucumber fields and the tomato fields and the corn fields, and the folk that lived there, we raised on the farm, but then we got too big for the farm. So you know what they did? Because the harvest needs picking. So they hired out in different states, and they brought in laborers just for the purpose of picking the harvest. I stopped by to tell somebody there's some laborers that's taking your stuff because you won't go get it. Somebody's got that joy you're looking for, that peace that surpasses all understanding, because you won't go get it. You keep looking for it to harvest, and you want to go to the store and get it. You won't go to the Amish market where you got to wash it. You rather go to the store where you don't know what happened to it. But because it's all wrapped up, ain't no worms in it. You ain't got to worry about no bugs. Somebody need to understand that all things organic ain't nothing but fresh from the ground. The unskilled. He said the church has been mesmerized by fame. Everybody's seeking titles instead of blessings. Everybody got to be in the top level of the church. He said, nobody want to work. Somebody say amen. God told me one morning, it's been about 3 weeks now, and he was showing me this thing because I was in anticipation of getting my shots in my knees. And you know, when you need something, God will deal with you. So I got up in the morning and I spun and put my, you know when you hurt and you got to do everything in phases. You know, I noticed something because I got my knees shot now. But a couple days ago, I was. Watch this now. I turned on the bed. Then I put my feet down. And then I sat there and meditated for a minute because I knew pain was coming. I'm trying to help somebody. There's some stuff you're dealing with that pain is associated with. But you got to go through the process. I put my feet on the ground, and this is what God told me. He said, put your knees in it. Y'all ain't hearing me. That thing that hurts. He said, put your knees in it and push. Oh, my God. He was speaking to me so loud. I wanted to go downstairs, but my knees, even though they was feeling a certain way, they wasn't acting a certain way. What you talking about, Bishop? In the process of manifestation, you still going to go through a little something-something. But you got to get to the place where you realize victory is already yours. He said, put your knees in it. One thing I begin to understand, even though they still hurt, as I pushed, as I used my knees, I moved towards the bathroom and my pace picked up. Oh, y'all ain't hearing me for real. You know, you might be moving slow right now, but you just keep putting your knees in it. Hey, you all ain't getting this for real. See, some of us ain't got our prayers answered yet because we ain't put our... And I'm thinking, God, you're marvelous. And he said, listen, the church is directed by vision that I sent. But the church is forgetting the part where I say, write it and make it plain. See, the body of the church is the knees. And if the knees ain't moving, the vision ain't being obtained. Ah, y'all ain't get that. See, you are the knees, and if you're sitting there still hurting, and you're swelling, and it's painful for you to just make it through the next day. As a matter of fact, some of us can't even get through the next moment because we're so drenched with pain. We taking this and we taking that and we listening at this and we listening at that and we quoting this and we quoting that. And the problem ain't the state we're in. The problem is the state of the church leadership. Because the leadership wants to move the church, but it don't want to move the people. It don't want to put no time in with the knees. It don't want to put no time in trying to help the pain. It wants you to just push through it. That's what they say. Mature in things. Don't you know God showed me something? He said, you know why you preach the body shop? Because the body shop is a place where all the wrecks come. See, we come to this church because it's a place for the wrecks. You're a wreck whether you know it or not. And God's trying to fix you. You're an apprentice in pain. You ain't never seen a body shop say, you carry your car there, and they say, nah, it's too banged up. See, but the church will say that. It only wants certain pain. Don't understand that you just got to go back and get another class of understanding so you can teach that class. But everything you go through is a setup for a straightening out. I was telling Ella Rick, man, look at the anointing just flowing out of Audrey. See, when you can centralize your pain, the anointing says, I want to use what the enemy tried to destroy you with to break some yokes and help some people say, if she can deal with it, I can deal with it. And the greatest suffering that you're dealing with, God is trying to tell somebody, go through it. He said, go through it. A good leader understands that it ain't about them. It's about fixing the body, straightening it up, taking the dents out. Somebody say amen. Man, God, he reshapes you, puts a little putty on you, puts some clear coat, and you shine. He say you come out like, y'all reading your Bible? Look, when you come out like that, that means you must have went in a different way. How many of y'all go to the car wash when your car clean? Well, I do sometimes. I got that monthly. You know what I'm saying? I got that blessing on blessing. If I feel like washing my car, I go do it. Because I'm paying for it. You ain't hear me. I'm paying for it. If you paying for it, you might as well enjoy it. Ain't nobody getting it. He said, listen, the vision. See, the vision ain't all this other stuff that people are aspiring to obtain. Can I help you with your vision? Go to Luke, the 4th chapter. And it reads something like this. And there was delivered unto him the book of the prophet. And when he opened the book, look at your neighbor and say, you got to open the book. You just can't carry it around. Somebody say amen. You can't look religious. You got to open the book. There's a lot of books in my kitchen that talk about cooking. But I don't open them. Somebody say amen. So don't expect me to be able to cook. So watch this. If you ain't studying your word, stop expecting people to lean towards you. Oh, I talk a whole lot of whatever you think, call them things, like I just did with the car wash, but underneath it is scripture. Somebody say amen. You got to do what you got to do to get the ear. Because so or so. It said, listen, verse 18, it said, the spirit of the Lord. We talk about the anointing. Somebody say amen. The anointing, the spirit of the Lord is on me. Ain't about you saying. I didn't mean to look that way. Ain't about you preaching. I didn't mean to look that way. I'm looking this way. He said, the spirit of the Lord is on me. Watch this. Because. Somebody say purpose. All that anointing you say you got, don't let it be annoying. It said, watch this, because he has anointed me to minister, to preach the gospel to the without. He has sent me to heal broken hearted. You know why your heart broke? Because God said, I wanted to, look, we'll say, it got to be wrought through you. Well, if you're going to help somebody broken hearted, your heart got to have been broken. The Bible say, let a seed fall to the ground. Say yeah. Watch this. To preach deliverance. The anointing is to produce freedom. It's to tear down, destroy. Get rid of, make free. See, your pain, your suffering is to make somebody else free. And we would gravitate to that. If we understand all I got to do is go get my stuff and stop worrying about getting it. Because the devil have us worrying about the stuff more than the reason why we got it. Somebody say amen. I'm anointed. I got a new position on my... No, you didn't. That ain't got nothing to do with it if you're just sitting there counting the money. If you ain't sharing with nobody the goodness of the Lord, because that's what the anointing is for. You got to realize your church can be anywhere. Somebody say amen. I was getting my car fixed the other day to go on the road, and I'm sitting there with a lady, and we talking. Come find out she born 3 days after me. That means she my age. And we were talking about the Lord because she works in a pantry. Somebody say amen. And she thought it was nothing. And she's up close to her pastor. And God, you know, because when folks start talking about that, I'd be a little leery because I'm not trying to be your pastor. But if God give me a word for you, I'm not afraid to tell you because my purpose is right. And we got to talk, and that's how we got to the birthday. Somebody say amen. You can't get, watch this, you can't get to the heart of matter if you don't put your heart in the matter. It's going to cost you something. You got to not be fearful. She said, I don't want to get on nobody's nerve. Yes, I do. Said the angel came and stirred up the water. When are you going to begin to embrace the characteristics of your God? Because this ain't our world. We just here. Don't act like it don't matter. It does matter. Every moment you got to breathe with. It's to help somebody because the Spirit of the Lord came to set somebody. He said, recover sight to the blind. It's folk that don't see this, man. And the body of Christ should not be blind. We should be happy about this stuff, not worrying about it, to set at liberty. Watch this. Them that are bruised. Those that have been through something, you've been purposed to free them. Somebody say, I'm free. Thank God I'm free. Now go to work. Put your hands together. Give the Lord some praise. God told me, tell me, one of the reasons why we're so cockeyed in the church because we trying to get vision without the visionaire. Come here, Peter, John 22. Say, Peter fished all night and he was right in the midst of his harvest. I just stopped by to tell somebody, you in the midst of your harvest. But watch this, you're fishing on the wrong side. Some of us think it's our great ability to preach. That ain't it. It's got to be about our ability to reach. And Jesus is calling out to his church right now. Pick up your net. Try my way. Since I'm the one that called you. You're sitting right in everything you want. Now watch this. God deals with your need before he sends you on your journey. Why now? Because he don't want you worrying about your needs. I heard the scripture say, I will supply. Are you hearing me? Man, all you got to do is say, what does it take for me to get my net right? We talk about God won't put more on us than we can bear. That's why you only got $5. Because God already know you ain't going to tithe. I'm going to take care of your needs, but you ain't getting no desires yet. You want the window open, but you ain't tithing. Why did he stop there? Because I don't know where you are. I'm just telling you what the Lord is saying. And it ain't wrote down. But he said, you want the window to open and you won't even go in the house. You standing outside waiting for it to get open for somebody else. Somebody say amen. Y'all get mad with me later after you get blessed. Why didn't he tell me that sooner? That's why I want you to be mad with me. Why didn't I know that last week? He said, listen. God said, listen, Peter, you've been out there all night. Some of us have been in church for 50 years and still ain't happy. We don't know joy. We know church. We go religiously. I go to work religiously. Somebody say amen. But spiritually, I go to the bank because my work produces what I'm doing it for. I'm not going to get no friends. I'm going to work. Somebody say amen. When I come into the Lord, I come to go to work. And he will add to me. Church, what's that? I don't know what that is. It don't mean I ain't been through something. Somebody say amen. But I come for God. I don't come for y'all. I don't mean no harm. Y'all beautiful people. He said, but if the Lord don't build a house, if he ain't building the relationships, stop expecting them to work. Look what God says. He said, Jesus said unto them, after you get it, here it is again, bring me them fish. He said, bring them to me. Look, he filled the net so bad that they were having a trouble. They were having a problem bringing the fish up. Mm-hmm. I like this. Jesus said this to Simon. No. In verse 10, he said this. Jesus said to them, bring up the fish which ye have now caught. And when he told me that, he said, bring of the fish. Are you hearing me? He didn't say bring all the fish. When God gives you something, you got to bring of it. You got to bring it back to him. Watch this. Now watch what I'm saying here. It said, and Simon Peter went up, drew the net. Now, he prophesied to him. After he'd been in this trouble all night fishing, Jesus talking about abundance before he even saw it. He said, listen, Simon Peter went up and drew the net to land full of great fishes, 153. And for all there were so many, yet was not the net broken. What are you saying? God told me to tell you whatever you're dealing with. The way he's going to bless you. What you're dealing with ain't going to destroy you. What you're going through is just part of the process. But you're not going to lose. It's going to add to you. I just stopped by to tell somebody, go get your harvest. A harvest means it's already your season. You got to stop looking for another season. You already in your season. All you got to do is do the work. Go get it. Stop. Watch this. I'm trying to end this thing. Look at your neighbor and say, but you got to put your knee in it. Romans 14:11 say, for it is written, as I live, saith the Lord, every knee shall bow. You got to put your knees in it. He said, and then you got to confess to God, I know you got me. He said, when heavy, watch this. Anybody used to lift weights or still doing it? I'm kind of doing it. Somebody say, yeah. I can come to realize I'm in the kind of stage of my life. I'm kind of getting old because I'm not going to receive that. But it keep happening whether I receive it or not. Y'all need to understand what I just said. You're going to get it whether you receive it or not. Watch this. I remember when I was just starting, you know, because you can be strong. There's a lot of strong Christians. Till something comes. I remember the guys in the gym. See, you got to look at the people that look like they know what they're doing at least to try to get your result. So if you all like that in the gym, I'm going to at least watch you. I'm going to try to figure out what you're doing. Then I'm going to check the results. See, some people want the results without trying the technique. Somebody say, yeah. But, I'll ask them, bro. How you get that thing up to 8 inches? He said, bro, you got to put your knees in it. Seriously, he said, when you lifting weights,
Don't try to lift it with your back. Too many of y'all trying to lift with your back. God said you got to lift with your knees. See, you put the, that's why you can handle all the weight. Because you put your knee, when you put your knees underneath that thing, and just rock with it sometimes. Don't wobble. Say it!
That was for you, Sis Pastor Cammy.
I don't know. Sometimes you got to wobble. However you do it. It wasn't it, huh? I made it go home and go YouTube. Somebody say yeah. But he told me, watch this. Here it is. He said, when you put your knees in it, he said, you will have a weight transfer. You know, the problem, it would transfer up. Your knees will stop hurting and you'll end up being in a place of praise. Oh, y'all ain't hear me for real. Watch this. Matthew said, take my yoke upon you and learn of me. Watch me transfer that weight. Just put your knees in it. Yes, sir. Just put your knees in it. And when you're on your way up, go get your stuff. Go ahead and get your harvest. Because God already proclaimed it. As a matter of fact, Joel put it like this in the 3rd chapter, verse 3. Just the A part of that scripture. Put your sickle in. He said, the harvest. Just put it in. Wherever you touch, it's a blessing. I got 4 points, but I'm not going to mess with y'all for real. I got to because God told me. Y'all, no, I'm going to say it because this might come back. Put your knees in it. I'm going to stop right there. As they say at work, I'm going to give you some of your time back. Look at your neighbor. You ain't lost nothing. You ain't hearing me for real. God said, I'm giving you some of your stuff back. Everything that cankerworm tried to steal from you. If you just stop where you are right now, in the midst of what you're dealing with, get down on your knees. Confess to the Lord that all things, it may not feel good, but if I keep my knees in it, it's going to work out for my good. Say yeah. Say yeah. Somebody bless the Lord. Come on, join me. Bless the Lord. I will bless the Lord at all times. I'm going to continually praise him. Come on, magnify the Lord with me. He heard my cry. He told me, say, after you suffered, I don't know why I'm dealing with this. I didn't do nothing. I don't deserve this. I'm talking directly to somebody right now. You ain't going to find the answer for what you're dealing with. Other than in Peter. See, self-suffering is one thing. But righteous suffering is another. Can I paraphrase it for a minute? He said, handle your suffering right. Don't let it pull you away from me. Don't let it change your character. God said, ain't a thing wrong with you. He just going to make your enemy your footstool. And he's going to bless him too. He said, but after you suffered a little while, I will establish you. You ain't established yet. You're just walking into your future, baby, your destiny. God got greater things for you than you can imagine. You say, eyes have not seen. He said, I'm going to move all, watch this. He got to move all that stuff out of your heart so he can move this other stuff in. He said, I will make you perfect. I will exalt you. I heard Deuteronomy say the world gonna call you blessed. Because they know you got to be blessed to be able to have dealt with what you dealt with. I'm trying to talk to somebody right now. Go get your stuff. Get on your journey. Start claiming it as if it's already there. Glory. He said, let. Jesus still waiting for some of us in the natural. But when he came, he knew it was a completed work. He knew Melvin was going to get right. He knew you were going to get right. He came for you. I heard an old song we used to sing. It wasn't the nails. It was his love for us. God say, go get your stuff. Go get your stuff. Go get your joy. Go get your peace. Go get your health. I just found out the other day there are more than two types of diabetes. What else they gonna give us? Four, they up to four, wasn't it? Five, Jesus. They want to get your mind. They say, you're a controlled diabetic. I said, I ain't got no control. I still eat them cookies every once in a while. Somebody say amen. Ain't no need to lie to myself. But I try to make sure I'm on my way to my harvest at the gym. I want to at least act like I'm getting it out of me. Somebody say amen. Amen. Talk about gyms. Let me give a shout out to PG's new gym. That thing is the bomb. I'm headed there on Thursday for spin class. Since I got my shots, I'm going to spin. Clipping and everything. If y'all see me coming down Missouri Avenue, I'll be attached to the bike, but I'm going to do it. Listen, what am I saying? You want stuff different? You got to do something different. It's a shame. I get on the bike, I can stay on that 30 minutes. That means I got more to go. Somebody hear me now. You ain't as far as you can go yet. Glory. The harvest is plenteous. But the come waters are few. The complainers are a lot of them. But I'm going to get my stuff. Hear me when I tell you, I'm going to get my stuff. I'm going to say this and I'm finished. I really am. We were at a homegoing service yesterday. Alicia's mom, grandmom was 90 years old. Watch this. That woman was so blessed. You know I got a witness. She sent her tithe even after she was gone. Y'all ain't hearing what I'm telling you. She sent her tithe and she was gone. She already knew she already had her reward. Somebody say amen. Come on, go get your stuff. Glory! Glory!